Alright guys, Jamziboy Minecraft here, and I uploaded a video about me, you know, like a speed build, a sped up build of me building something, and that was greeted really well. And then somebody said in the comments that I should do a build where I just build it and talk through it. So I'm not going to build something as big as the inn, which is over there, but I can't be asked to fly. So, and one of the requests was a library, so I thought, you know, I'll just build a library and talk about what I'm doing. So it makes sense, kind of. I'll try and make it as interesting as I can. No promises. So, the first thing about libraries is they are generally quite grand buildings. That's the same in the UK and the US. What's also the same in the UK and the US is that they are generally quite high. They have big windows, lots of light, because, you know, you want to read. And they tend to have a kind of central area where you can, you know, you can go get a book, open it, read it. You know, like films like National Treasure, where he goes to open the book and it might be National Treasure? I don't know. Anyway, so the idea is I'm going to build quite a big, grand building, a bit like a town hall. You could actually, I guess, use it for a town hall. I haven't done any preparation, but we'll see how it goes. So the first thing I'm going to choose is blocks. I'm going to be using steps, because they look like pillars. Cobblestone, because it's just a nice, normal wall. Stone for detailing and stuff like that. And I guess that is all I will use for now. I'll take some glass as well. So, first I'm going to think about the entrance. It's a library, it's got to have a double door, let's face it. So, I'm going to mark that out with two pillars. And that is going to be the way to get in. Now, I'd quite like to have a kind of porchy area because that'll make it look quite grand. And to make the roof, I'm going to be using half steps like this. I don't know how well this is going to look. Actually, I'm not. I'm going to use stone stairs like that. How does that look? That's pretty naff, actually. I'm going to get rid of that. Okay, better idea. If I've got the idea of that's where I want the doorway to be, I'll build the rest of the building first. So, I need to choose how I want the front to look. And I want to have two big windows, one on each side of the door. So I'm going to go back a bit from the doorway because I'd quite like to have, as I said, like a porch. So I'll put these there to remind myself that that is going to be a kind of doorway entrance. Then I want one for the wall and then a window and then another one for the wall and then one for the corner. So just marking things out on the ground, I always do this. It's kind of unnecessary and a bit OCD, but I don't know. It's nice, especially if you guys are trying to follow along. It will help out a lot. So, and I've got two windows along this side wall like that, and the back, make it identical to the front, I guess. So that's that, then two, and then that and that. Is this right? This doesn't quite look right. No, right. Okay, so this back wall here, if I did it in line with that, then that would be like so. So how could I make this not so weird? I couldn't. Right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to shorten, make this window bigger, so this is now all window, and I'll mark the window with that, and make these windows only small. So I'm still keeping the themes, like Okay, I've realised why I might not have done one of these before. I can't talk and think. I'll do my best, but yeah. So now I've mapped out the walls and the window spaces, I can decide whether I want a window sill. And I think I will have one because it will just look a bit weird if it doesn't. So I'm going to just go around putting these in. And these are going to be underneath the windows. I'll also increase this. I have an idea of how I want this to look, I'm just not quite sure how to do it. But when we look at it from the front, we can start to get an idea of the dimensions. So I'm thinking that this is actually a bit small. But for video's sake, I'm going to keep going with it. But maybe it's a bit squashed. Oh well, we'll see how it goes. and I'm going to build at these corners. If I was building this out of wood, I would be doing exactly the same thing, except with wood, obviously. These are the kind of stages I go through when I think of a house design. First one is mapping out the walls, picturing it in my head, deciding on the actual dimensions themselves. I would talk a little bit about a magic ratio, but I think I'm going to make a video exactly on that. And the magic ratio is basically a ratio of length to height, which the human eye just finds pleasing. You might have heard of it before, it's really weird, but there's just this natural shape that humans like, and this is pretty close to it. But as I said, I will do a video just about that at some point, because I think it's really cool. But then I'm really sad, so let's bring up these pillars as well. I'm getting a bit confused which one's my window frame, which one's my pillar now. How's that? Let's leave these all at 3. There we go. So there's our walls starting up. Now I'm going to bring up the cobblestone. My mouse is really... it acts up when I record. It's fine otherwise. Maybe it's just the frame rate that's bothering me. Playing in 30 FPS is a bit annoying. Okay. So let's look at this now. Everything looks to be in quite a good proportion. The walls are working nicely with each other because of the different colours and stuff like that. So I'm just going to put in this just to see how the brown of the window looks in in conjunction with the wall. Nailed it. This is a feature of Optifine, by the way, if you didn't know this already. You can set time to day only, and my weather is off. That just makes, seriously, if you're building a big thing, it's worth doing. So the windows are too small. Obviously, this is going to be a library, so I want to go up quite high. I want to have nice, tall windows. I might go up another layer on top of this, but for now, I'm just going to go up another one. Just to see kind of how that looks, and I can't really get a judge of how it looks yet, so I'm going to add a bit more. That's another key thing to do when building. If you want to know what something looks like, do it. Or at least do a little bit of it so you don't waste too much time. And then see if you can kind of picture it in your head. And if you can't picture it in your head, then add a bit more. Then try again. And keep doing that until you can picture exactly what you want it to look like and what it does look like. And for goodness sake, if you don't like what it looks like, change it. There's a lot of people who finish a house and they are like, "Oh, I'm proud of this." It's like, no, you're not, because you just did it. You have to change your mind. Otherwise, how can you improve? So I'm thinking that's quite nice for a kind of ground floor. I'm not sure whether I want to do two layers on this. I'm actually thinking about having a... yeah. Okay, so what I'm going to do for this is have one story and a balcony. So if I picture myself underneath, so there's bookcases coming up three blocks, then I'm going to have a balcony around this edge, and I'm actually going to put that in now, just so I can envision the height. Because I like to think just as much about the interior as I do about the exterior. Because, you know, it's quite easy to make an exterior look right if you have absolutely no consideration for the inside. But that's not fun, is it? I like to think of everything in my builds. That's the kind of thing I go for. Like, it has to look as if, as realistic as possible. You have to think about every scenario. That's why I'm actually quite interested in thinking about doing a whole series, especially when 1.8 comes out with rivers, building a town from scratch, as in, like, I will, using admin powers, not in the Let's Play, that'll be separate, but building a town from scratch, like, I'll say, this is the first house, and this was built by, you know, this farmer or something like that, and then someone added a weir so that they could cross the river and stuff like that. It's, I know it sounds really sad, but it's the kind of thing I really enjoy doing. So now I'm going to look at this, see what it looks like. I'm really not happy with this front piece. And I don't know how to make it look right. Oh, here's an interesting idea. Will this work? No, that looks retarded. Look at this. What if I put these back in here? That. Nope. that. Stone, especially on this texture pack, because it's so plain, it tends to look a bit weird when it's on its own. I mean, obviously I've used it for the roofs over there, but they're kind of, it's excusable for roof, but when you mix it, especially with cobblestone or half blocks, stone starts to look a bit weird and out of place. So that's why I like to use it for detailing, because it makes a nice tone change without actually being a part of the building. It's kind of hard to explain, but how does that look? No, I don't like that. Keep it how it was. Don't fix what ain't broke. Right, so let's start on the second layer now, and I'm thinking whether I want to change the windows. I think I'm going to leave the windows how they are and just continue them up and see how they look. So I'm going to go up three floors, or maybe two. I'm going to go up two. I think it would probably work better for the interior if I went up three. But if I make this building too tall, it will look weird, so I'm going to go up two blocks all around. I'm also just going to check if you can actually hear my voice. Oh, you can. Good. I'm going to check all the time since I cocked up that last recording. That made me so angry. I just finished doing a Let's Play, a whole Let's Play, 25 minutes. I didn't have my mic plugged in. Just cried. I didn't really cry, I just got really angry and started hitting things. Okay. Actually, this is looking like a nice height. I'm considering going up another floor, but first I'd like to see what these windows look like if I add in the floor level. That's kind of hard to explain, but I will show you in just a second. And this is obviously going to be a window here. So that looks okay, but now what does it look like if I go like that? No, I don't like that. I think it looks better like that. There we go. Let's have a look around the side. They all look nice and big and grand. Looking a bit churchy from this end, a bit like a chapel. But never mind. What really makes this building is going to be the roof, and I will explain why when I start building it. Now, I want to see what this looks like if I use... No, it won't look right in wood. This archway is going to bug me. I'm going to get rid of the whole archway for now. I'll redo that at the end. Yeah. Window there, maybe. And then the doors. I'll put in the doors just to see what they look like. Oops. Hey-o. Yeah, that's okay. I'm actually going to raise them up. And I'm going to have steps out the front, because that will make it look a lot more grand. There you go. A town hall just wouldn't look right if it was on the same level as the ground. And then you'll go in on kind of like a platform, which will be the desk where you take out books and things like that, and then you actually go down into the area where all the shelves are. Yeah, that's looking good. I still need to put on this facade. How about that? With kind of support beams here. How does that look? That looks okay, actually. I'm going to leave it as that for now. I can always change my mind later. But now let's start on the roof. So the roof is going to be a kind of... I think it's quite an English design. I don't know. I've seen it a lot in England anyway. So I guess that's enough. And it's... I'm not sure of the exact story behind it, but I think it was to copy big grand buildings at the time, because who looked like forts? So that you make your house look epicer, I guess. I think that was the idea behind it, but basically it has battlements on top, quite small battlements, not really useful ones. And let's see how this looks. And I put these on top. There. The proportions are actually quite nice there. Let's make that into more of an archway. Yep, I'm thinking that's looking good, so I need to now do this. Okay, and then one in each corner. And I'm going to make these, obviously I'm making these coming from each side so that they actually look symmetrical. I'll put that there. Six on each side, and then this one goes like this, and then there's that there. And that there. Now we have our kind of battlemented building like that, but it's definitely not complete yet, because on top of that, you'd have a roof, and I'm going to build the roof out of, I'm thinking half blocks, and I go right from here. The reason I like using half blocks is because they look really grand. I hope you'll agree with that. They look very, I don't know what the word would be, they just work. Now I think that that is too low, yeah, way too low. In which case, I think I'm going to make it out of wood. Because if I made it out of cobblestone steps as well, there'd be way too much cobblestone going on, that it would just look weird. So I'm going to, first of all, add a rim all around the outside. I hope that you guys like this kind of video, because it's actually very easy for me to do. Because normally when I do tutorial, I have to build it, and then remember how I built it, do a test copy, delete the test copy, and then do it all again, cut it up into segments, and then edit it all. But if you follow this, you should be able to get a gist on how to build it, and all will be well. I'm going to have a stone end on here. And it will come right up to the edge, I guess. And I can make something nice out of this design, because the roof is going to have an overhang. Nope, it's not. If it does, actually, yeah, it's got to have an overhang, otherwise it just looks weird. So I'm going to bring these back. And I will do some cool patterning within this triangle. My nose is itching really badly. I have no idea why. Okay, so there's triangles, and now we're going to do the steps. And this is going to be a very basic roof. There's going to be no like clever joinery or anything. It's just going to be two sides coming up to the middle. Because of that, it's the kind of roof that they had at the time. Bonk, bonk, bonk. Bonk, 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 bonk. Now what I'll do is flash up an image of the kind of building that I'm trying to create. And the reason I haven't actually looked at the image now is because I don't like copying buildings, because that way you don't... it's going to sound so nerdy, but I'm actually quite interested in this kind of stuff. I want to learn how they built, like what they look like. You know, I want to learn it through trial and error rather than just finding an image and copying it, because why did that run out? What the fuck? Strange. Yeah. I don't know, it's hard to explain. But I'm sure some people out there will agree with me, and some people will just be like, what the fuck? So if you're thinking, what the fuck is he on about, then just shh, go away. Be quiet. This is great. When I'm concentrating and talking, I just ramble. Just keep talking on and on and on. Now if I put them there, then I've got this kind of patterning effect going on here. And that actually looks quite good. Oh, I don't know. I don't know. We'll see. I'm thinking that this roof comes up a bit far. It just looks a bit out of place. Maybe if I'd set the roof back a bit. Actually, I can actually just replace this, and I will show you how I do that, because some of you might not know how to use this. This is single player command. You get a wooden axe. I'm going to select this corner, and then I'm going to come up from this corner, like that, and select that corner. And I'm going to forward slash cut. Oops, cut. Note the two forward slashes, doesn't work with one forward slash. Oh, I just failed, hold on, wait. Forward slash, undo. I need to cut it from a very specific place, like this. So forward slash, cut. Now I'm going to go down the block, not moving at all. It's very important you don't move because it copies it in relation to your position. So because I've gone down the block, now when I paste, the roof will appear down the block. So forward slash, paste. And I've actually moved the roof down one whole block. And look, it's not coming into the room or anything like that. So yeah, that looks a bit better. That's a bit more like what I was going for. It's quite nice. Maybe it needs some kind of... needs some sort of peak here. That's hard to explain. There we go. Just something to give it a bit more shape. And because that looks a bit odd, I'm going to place the direction of these just to make that gap smaller. Oops. There you go, just that little bit of change in the roof makes so much difference. So, I guess we will start on the inside, but first I'd like to sort out this porch, because I don't like it. By the way, now I'm not using the fly command anymore, I'm using the fly mod by Zombie, because he's just done a new installer where you can literally just click on install and change some sliders around, and it's really nice. If you haven't used this already, then I really recommend it. I'm going to put some fences here and here. There we go. There, that looks a lot better than it was. So, let's go inside. Start on the inside. To do this roof all at once, because it's a square building, I can easily do this. I can just select one corner, select the other corner, forward slash set, and then choose the date block. I'm going to use 43, because this is probably my favourite block to use for flooring. Let's see how it looks, actually. Forward slash 1. That's stone, obviously, and I think it looks a bit cold. Forward slash 35, this would be wool. Too white for a public building. What else could I do it out of? I could try it out of wood. Push that 17, that's the other type of wood, like that. No, I'm going to stick with 43. I don't know, that looks cozy, doesn't it? And yeah, I like going for cozy buildings. Yeah, I'll leave it like that. So now I'm building the kind of bit that you get greeted by as you come into the library. Welcome. And I'm gonna use... No, I'm not. There's gonna be steps at the front here. No, too much, too far forward. Let's move this all back a bit. No, steps. Okay, and on one side there's going to be, this is going to be the area where the librarians go. I just destroyed a block, bugger. If you're interested, by the way, the commands I'm using are, oh, wait, I just had an idea. pistons. Yeah, the commands I'm using is /drops, and that prevents blocks being dropped, and that's so useful for this kind of thing. How the hell am I supposed to do this? Right, if I... Oh, for goodness sake. Ah, there we go. Right, so I might as well raise this whole area, because this is going to be the whole librarian area. And there's going to be a pillar coming up, and above it there's going to be an extra large kind of area, like a little booth. So this is where you're going to speak to the librarian, then you walk down these steps here. I'll make these proper steps. Why do blocks keep going disappearing from inventory? I don't quite understand that. Never mind. They'll have their own little stairs here to come up, and they'll have a wall, and I'll make that of stone. How's that look? That looks weird. That can be made out of, I think we'll make it out of that, cobblestone. Nope. Wood. See, if you don't experiment, you'll never get it right. There, I guess that'll do. You know what? I'm making a fucking library. Why don't I just make it out of books? Alright, so there we have it. There's our entrance. I'll move the stairs back a little bit. I just bit my lip and now it's bleeding. Yay. Okay. So now we've got the entrance sorted, this is where the librarians go, and this is going to be, I'll put a barrier here so you can't walk off. Or, I could just get rid of all this and put some, thingy, bookshelf. Now, obviously we don't want people coming straight in and nicking the books, so I'm going to turn off instant mine, instant mine. Get some paintings, and note that obviously if you're not using my texture pack, your paintings are going to be different, but if you're using my texture pack or John Smith's texture pack, then you'll have that painting that I just put down, and I'm going to keep going through until I find it again. I hate placing paintings, I always miss them. There we go. So now you can't nick books as you come in. There's also another painting that you could use up there, although I'm not sure how it's going to look. We shall see. No, don't want pots on the front of my thing, thank you. Oh, my nose is not even funny how itchy it is. It's really winding me up. Just want to get like a... There we go. And it looks retarded. That was a waste of time. Whatever. Alright, so we've got our paintings there, we've got a place for the librarians to go there, you come down here, so let's turn instant mine back on. And start placing our bookshelves. So, I'm going to have a thing here, and I can bring out the balcony a little bit more. And we'll just have some columns of bookshelves. So, if I plan this out, if I use this M wall as like a reference point, I can have 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And place them. These obviously come out quite a long way, so I can bring across the balcony. And there we have it, there's our first kind of area of bookshelves. Obviously I'm going to need to put some lighting up here to make it look a bit more natural. My nose is so itchy! Ugh, god damn it. That's annoying. Right, I'm going to bring the whole balcony up to 3, I think. That looks a bit odd, doesn't it? Let's build that out of that. Nope, that was weird. I guess it's going to have to be like that then, isn't it? Nope, this is weird. I can't leave it like that. That's too weird. Now, that is actually symmetrical. I can move these back. Yeah, that works. And I can move the steps back as well. Okay, so where was I? Bookshelves. And we'll repeat these on the other side. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I will leave that as it is. Or, ingenious plan. Ta-da! That's cool. That'll do. Now we've got all our bookshelves, and this is going to be our kind of reading area, where you come for book club and stuff. I'm still not happy about that. No, I don't want things not symmetrical. They will bug me. They will really bug me. I'm going to have to redo all this. Just for the sake of OCD. How's that? That's okay. It's okay, it still works, it's all fine. So this is going to be our seating area. I'm going to make the seats out of wood. And I'm going to have a table, I don't know. Okay, so I'm going to have one big table with lots of seats around it. And I'll plan out how many seats I'm going to have. I'm going to have, okay, if I put the table right up against the wall, then I won't have to worry about making that look normal. And I don't want it to go so far up against that that you can't walk around. And the chairs will have to go right up against the table, but that's fine. And then I'll have two chairs there, two chairs there. Four chairs. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to take my redstone torch, and I've already got some pistons. Turn on flying, and place all of these pistons like that. Then I'll take my chair, and I'm going to put one on each side. No, it's a bit of overkill. You want quite a big reading area. Like that. Yeah, so ideally there'd be some kind of blockage, like a wall in the middle, so that you couldn't see each other, but that's too hard to make in Minecraft, so I'm just going to leave it like that. That's cool, I'm happy with that. Now, we need a way of getting up to the second level, so I need to decide on where I'm going to put my stairs. Let's think. I guess I'm going to have to put them in one of these corners, and seeing as this side of the room is already ruined, I might as well ruin it some more. So, I will take a 3x3 staircase, and I will, let's put a block here. My note, seriously, why is it so itchy? It's really winding me up. Bonk, bonk, bonk. I'm making this a lot longer than I was intending on. Well, never mind. And I can make that into a nice little feature. Alright, so here's the stairs. Up the staircase. On you're on the top floor. So, I'm going to put bookshelves all along here. Except that's not symmetrical. Cannot happen. Cannot happen. Needs to be symmetrical. And also, we can't fall in. So I'm going to need to put a barrier up. And that's going to severely cut down the amount of space we have to play with. But, you know, you can't just not have a barrier. That would just look weird. So I guess I could just make these walls entirely bookcase. And see how that looks. Ah. Right. And now over here, I think I'm going to have some tables and chairs. So I'll have a table, it looks like, no, I will have these kind of tables so I can show you how to do it. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to take some TNT, no reason why it's TNT, it's just a bit easier. I'm going to take my tool, I'm going to left click on one, and then put it back, and then right click on the other one. I'm going to type in // replace TNT with 72, and 72 is the pressure plate thing. So now I have two tables. And that is how you make pressure plate tables, in case you did not know. Also gonna get some signs, like that, to finish off these chairs. And now we have another two seats upstairs. And everything is looking fine. Now, I can go up there and do this, the attic kind of thing. I'm actually gonna leave it open. I think it will look a lot nicer open. I need to fly up there. Ooh. Also, this will provide a lot more light, because light actually goes through stair blocks for some reason, unbeknown to man. Okay, I'm going to leave it there. I've dragged this on for way too long. Tell me in the comments whether you liked this video, whether you want me to do more. Leave your feedback on this building itself. I hope that if you want to build this yourself, then you'll be able to follow this tutorial. I hope you do like it, because that means that I can I can produce a lot more tutorials, and it's a lot easier for me. And I will be doing a new Let's Play when I figured out a few of the kinks, which you will have to watch the Let's Play to actually work out what the kinks are, because they're fucking annoying. And there is my library. Thanks for watching.